KILR. Taylor Games.
Gamers, simmers, and pilots, I am the Killer Gamer, and welcome to the World Tour featuring Sublogic Flight Simulator 2 on the Commodore 64. Yeah, it's interesting when I'm playing some of the other simulators, and even like the Microsoft one, you know, it's got jaggy edges. And then you go to the Commodore 64, and it's like, wow, this has got even more jaggy. It's like the lines are even thicker. So it takes a little bit to readjust my eyes in order to be able to make out what's going on. But anyway, let's go ahead and talk about the flight that we're going to be doing. Because... this one will be kind of lengthy, but we're going to do something interesting with it. So let me just go ahead and we'll pull up the map here. So this is the map for scenery disc number 9, and we are here at Pal-waukee. Now we're going to be kind of going not really back in the direction where it came from, but we're going to be going over here to Rock County. We're not landing here, though. We're going to do a touch and go. We're going to do another touch and go. There's really no special reason for it, but let me explain. So we'll do a touch and go here at Rock County, and then we'll go south and land here at Greater Rockford. So you've got Rock County, you got Greater Rockford. My original idea was to go to Greater Rockford, but then I saw Rock County and I'm just thinking, wouldn't it be cool, since you got two different rocks here, to just do another touch and go here and then head south to Greater Rockford? I figured, why not do something interesting like that? So that's what we're going to do. And Janesville is the VOR over here by Rock County, so we'll tune it in, and then we can tune in Rockford, and they're relatively close, so that's going to give us our distance and everything. So I think Janesville will come up. If it doesn't, then we'll tune in Northbrook, because we're close to it anyway. And the 300 radio is going to take us over to Rock. So we have a dark cockpit here. We're going to go ahead and just turn the batteries on and turn the lights on. Well, yeah, there's no batteries, but there are lights. So the L key, we're turning our lights on. Yay! And we'll go ahead and start the engine that's on the PC emulator. Sorry, not the PC emulator, Commodore 64 emulator. Tab M and then 5, and that didn't work. That worked. Trying to do the keys for the Commodore 64 is definitely a challenge. All right, let's get our nav radio set up here. Tab NN. Oh, my goodness. Hiccups. Okay, so 58.9 miles. And do our Tower of Vore now. It's roughly around 300. That's about right. We'll just set that right there, and we will worry about the takeoff when we get, or we'll worry about it when we take off. There's so many runways to choose from, I'm not sure which one to take. Let's pull up the map. That's the 4 key. You know what? I think the one that we're looking at, that we're, this one right here, that looks like a good one. Kind of hard to see. There's nothing but lines all over the place. Try to use your imagination. Imagine there is a runway here with a center line. And I think the runway just ran out. That happened quickly. Yeah. We are at the end of the run. I didn't think we got there that quickly, but okay. Get turned around here. Okay, I think one over here. All these lines all over the place. I don't know, pick a line. Line, I pick you. I have no idea. Here, we'll start to take off here. Yep, I think we're up in the air. Okay, there goes Pal-waukee. And now we're loading up some other stuff. In the air, so that's good. exactly where we are. Okay, so there is the Pal-waukee Airport. Somewhere off in this direction is Chicago O'Hare. Up that way is Milwaukee. Ugh. Yep, we got some IFR flying here. Rely on our instruments. Okay, Rock County. Let's take a look at the map here. I went to see, what was it, Janesville or something? Yeah, Rock County. Altitude is 807. And then Rockford, which has fuel, that's good, 735. Okay. There's actually a river that goes from Rock County to Greater Rockford, but it's dark, so we're not going to see it. But that same river goes north and connects with the three lakes that were at Madison, which we were at before. And we have exciting scenery here in front of us. Oh my. Well, we got some night flying. That's pretty much all that we're gonna see. I mean, that's Chicago behind us. Oh, there we go. We got a road. Okay, that works. Maybe that road will take us to Janesville. That way our flight won't be completely boring. Realized my flaps were down. I thought I had those up. used to have it memorized what RPM I needed to have here in order to have straight level flight. I think it was around 1900 or something. I don't know. I'm sure after all these flights, it'll come back to me. I'll figure it out again. I tell you what, if I need help going to sleep, all I gotta do is play the Commodore 64 flight simulator. It's not that it's boring, a little bit, but it's hard on the eyes, just, you know, staring at the screen and all the jagged lines and trying to focus it so you can actually read what's going on. Okay, we're going to go ahead and continue with our flight physics and aircraft control book. As discussed in the POH manual, which is the pilot's operating handbook, roll control will change the bank angle of the aircraft. So roll is this. So when you use your ailerons, you're going to turn, you're going to roll. Whereas if you use a rudder, it does this. You know, it kind of turns. It's like it's on a flat, like if you're on a flat surface and you're just kind of turning it, that's like the rudder. That's why the rudder is used on the ground, because you're on the surface. You don't want to use the ailerons because, well, you know, you don't want to bank, so. And I'm still going up. Come on. Let's see here. Application of left or right rotating pressure on the control yoke. Left or right aileron causes the aircraft to roll in the same direction as the application. Releasing pressure on the yoke, centering the aileron, stops the roll and maintains the bank angle obtained when the pressure was released. An aircraft in a bank will turn, change direction. The cause of this turn is illustrated in Figure 18A. So there's aircraft in a bank. I'm thinking like a bank with money and there's an aircraft in it, but no, that's not it. And there's also, I'll show that to you, but this goes without saying, but I'm pretty sure, you know, right there, that's an aircraft in a bank. The horizontal component of lift will pull the aircraft, and the aircraft will change heading in the direction of this pull. The classic analogy is illustrated in Figure 18B. It's basically like an arm swinging a bucket. So this is the, where are we at? Right here. See that? Little arm swinging a bucket. A full explanation of the turn is really a bit more complicated than this. As the banked aircraft begins to change its direction of movement, the nose is still pointing, at least momentarily, in the original direction of movement. The tail and other surfaces begin to act like the feathers of an arrow. The aircraft's nose changes direction as the aircraft constantly realigns itself into the relative wind. Let's stop and summarize. You know that pitch can control altitude or speed. Roll is used to control heading or change in heading. Oof, 46 miles. Yaw control. This is with the rudder. Rudder application will cause rotation about the vertical axis. Assuming that all other control inputs are held constant, the application of rudder causes a change in relative wind along the longitudinal axis. During most aspects of flight, the purpose of yaw control is to keep relative wind aligned with the longitudinal axis. Auto coordination mode on Flight Simulator 2 applies rudder for you. Therefore, this alignment will be of little concern to you during your initial flights. Well, I have the auto coordination off, so that way I can use the rudder separately to make fine-tune adjustments when lining up the runway. It's just something I figured out when I was playing this, because I had auto coordination on and I try to adjust, and then it would turn this way and turn that way, and then it would turn too much and I'd crash, and then, you know, then I would rage quit, and well, I don't know. Don't know about rage quitting, but anyway. I swear I thought I would never be able to land on a runway. Eventually I was able to get it. Drag and lift control. Generally speaking, the first few notches of flaps mostly increase lift, while the last notch of flaps adds mostly drag. Flap operations will be practiced in flight lesson number 4. Thrust control. Assuming that you are in unaccelerating straight and level flight, an increase in power will cause the aircraft to nose up. The nose up tendency is a result of the aircraft's pitch stability discussed previously. Increased dynamic pressure causes extra tail down force. If you do not counteract this tendency by pitching the nose down, the nose will rise to new equilibrium point, resulting in an airspeed lower than level flight airspeed. The effect of stable tail down force means that a reduction in power will allow the tail to rise and nose lower. The new equilibrium airspeed will be higher than your level flight airspeed. As discussed in the stability section, power's effects on airspeed go contrary to many preconceived ideas on power use. A change in power must be counteracted by an adjustment in pitch pressure in order to achieve the main level flight use of power, or airspeed control. It is very important that you consider this stability effect, since airspeed control problems are caused by pitch stability. Sloppy pilots who don't adjust pitch pressure during changes in power will gain airspeed during power reductions on final approach to landing. Again, only a proper pitch pressure adjustments are made will more power give more airspeed, and less power reduce airspeed, and then that airspeed and down up speed. And did you all get that? Oh. So we're almost on the 300 radio to Janesville, but we still got 40 miles to go. We are getting our flights set up in preparation for flying over Lake Michigan, which we will be doing during the daytime. So don't worry, we will get to see it instead of black. With blue dots for horizon line. Alright. Where's my phone here? I'd pull it up on the screen, but I think whenever I click out of the emulator, it like, it doesn't pause it, but it like freezes the graphics or something. Alright, keep an eye on this time here for a moment. See this 18? And it's 2 seconds, 3 seconds. I'm going to click out of it right now. Alright, you see that? It stopped at 18:07. Now if I click on the, yeah, click on the emulator, and it kind of, it didn't pick up where it left off. It's just kind of like it was moving on its own already. So, I mean, yeah, it's not like you're going to miss anything within the 5-10 seconds that it's, you know, you don't see the screen, but Rex Simulations, did you know? Yeah, I knew Flight Simulator 2020 was going out and coming out, and there may not be much demand for Rex stuff. CNET, the new Star Wars trilogy is worse than the prequels. So how long did it take them to figure that out? Star Trek, I was going to say Star Trek Discovery, but that's not correct. The short track for Star Trek, they had a recent thing with Spock and Number One from Pike's Enterprise, which is the Star Trek Discovery version, in regards to Tribbles. I think it's an origin story. And I haven't watched it yet, but I need to check that out. Amazon is firing its delivery firms. Huh. More than 2,000 workers in 8 states will lose their jobs as Amazon terminated its relationship. I think I mentioned it before, the Commodore 64 emulator that I'm using is CCS64. CCS64. See, and then there's another emulator called Vice, and then there is, it's like Commodore 64 Forever or something like that. I mean, there's Amiga Forever, but then they have an emulator for the Commodore 64 called, C64 Forever, I think. And you know, the one that I've always been able to get it to work is CCS64, so I just stick with it. And it looks like it's still out. The guys from Sweden. It is an accurate and very popular Commodore 64 emulator, which can play Commodore 64 formatted cartridges, demos, games, and music. And there's a video for version 3.9, that's the one that I'm using. Let's go to the CCS64 home page. By the way, if you do want to get the Commodore 64 emulator, it is ccs64.com. Pretty simple. So I don't think they ever got to version 4. I think... Oh, they're at 3.9.2. I'm at 3.9. They have a 3.9.2. Which works with Windows XP Vista 7.8. Windows 98. Me 2000. Register. $30 to register the software. Mine's not registered. I didn't realize there was a registration. I wonder if I got mine before they started doing the registration thing. Let's get ourselves turned. We're like moving away from our radial there. 29.5 miles away. Turning left, but it tends to turn right a tad bit. It's probably because I'm not in auto coordination or something, so. And yeah, I think that'll do it. Okay, so let's move back here. Well, in 2015, emulationrealm.net was saying that CCS64 is by far the best C64 emulator available for Windows. It's shareware, but it's not limited. Okay, so you don't have to register it. On Reddit, someone says they only use VICE for the VIC-20. So VIC, VIC, E for emulator, VICE. The interface in CCS64 is way better. Press F10 and use the arrow keys to navigate. Try versus C64 forever. Should I buy C64 forever? Well, that was back in 2010. How about we skip to something new? C64 forever, all-in-one C64 emulator games, demo scene, and support. Here is best C64 emulator on Reddit. Well, we know Reddit's going to be relatively newer than some of that other stuff. Okay, so one person says Vice. Vice apparently emulates the drive sounds. One person says they always like CCS 64. BMC 64, what the heck is that? I never heard of that one before. And someone recommends C64 debugger. Then there's Z64K. Someone says it works best on a Raspberry Pi. Apparently there's an archive, I don't know if this thing still works, but it's like 18 gigabytes, and it has every Commodore 64 game and every demo ever made. I don't think you need that much. Frodo. I've used Frodo before. Someone's saying that C64 Forever is just a front end to Vice. I don't know. Well, let's go to the Lemon Retro Store. That's where some Commodore 64 stuff is at. My goodness, that's small. Are you considering buying C64 Forever? Like you, I wondered if it was worth buying. It looked good, and it seemed to do everything I needed, so I went ahead and took the plunge and bought it. Here are some things you should know if you decide to do the same. C64 Forever uses the RP9 file format. That means that it will take C64 games already on your computer, whether in T64, tape, or D64, disk, format, convert them to the RP9 file format and play them. This makes things easy for you. C64 Forever specializes in one-click gaming. However, you will need to do some work if you have a game that uses multiple game files. You will need to combine these files into one file so C64 Forever can play them. You will not need to convert your game files to RP9 if you import them, which means that you allow C64 Forever to play your games without converting the file format. The only drawback to this is that you need blah, 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 blah. Nah. Yeah, that one sounds way too complicated. Yeah, use CCS64 if you want a Commodore 64 emulator. Like I said, it's played whatever I've thrown at it, which isn't much, but I've never had problems with it. I mean, it's always worked. And I've had this version 3.9 for a long time now. And the highest they've gotten to is 3.9.2. Well, that should tell you pretty much how stable this emulator is. It's so stable that they don't really need to do anything more to it. Okay, 16 miles away. That looks like that might be Janesville up ahead. Yeah, we've got speed loading in here. What that is? I don't think that's Rockford over there. Now the thing is, where is the airport? I think the airport's going to be off over here somewhere. I see a line right there. Maybe the airport is this little dot or something right there. Turning? What am I doing turning here? There's a dot here, and there's a dot down here. That's not the runway, is it? This thing's got like three runways. So that can't be it. We're 12 miles away. Maybe it's a road. Whoa, there it is. There it is. All right, we'll start moving ourselves over there. Time that we drop some flaps. We'll do 1 degree there. Why I used a rudder, because the turning is really whoops. Yeah, see, this is why I was using a rudder to turn, because trying to bank and roll when you're trying to line up with a runway is ridiculous. Well, 8 miles to go. I'm going to switch our fuel. I mean, it's hard to know, you know, exactly if weight is being calculated, you know. So, let's see. Tab, F, arrow key. Okay, so it's now pointing over to the right tank. Able to determine if what we're seeing north of the airport, if that is Janesville or not. Let me see here. I think that's Janesville. I'm trying to find the airport itself. County Airport. Oh, did they change the name? I think it's now Southern Wisconsin Regional Airport. No, that's too far away. Heck, I don't know. Maybe Rock County doesn't exist anymore. or maybe Sublogic messed up the map some more. Yeah, when I look up Janesville Airport, what I get is the Southern Wisconsin Regional Airport. And Janesville's north of that, so... yeah, I don't know. So I guess maybe that's it, and that's Janesville. It's really hard to say. Down another thing of flaps here. That might be too much throttle down. Minor heading adjustments with the rudder. I'm gonna lower the rest of my flaps. Here. There we go. One thing's for sure, I don't need to check to see if the landing gear is down. This does not have retractable landing gear. Unlike the Microsoft Flight Simulator 2, where you're in a Cessna, and that does have retractable landing gear. Hard to tell if we're centered on that line or not. Appear to be coming in nice and easy here. bouncing, apparently. Trying to make sure I'm on the runway. Okay, we'll go ahead and power up here. She goes, and now it's time for us to make our turn south. Rockford is 110.8. So we got 24 miles to go. Okay, 192, that is the heading we want. Oh, relatively close to it. Oh, that was a little too much of a turn. Going completely out of control here. There's the airport, Rock County, or whatever it happens to be now. Ooh, flaps. Let's get the flaps up. Trying to level off somewhere around 3,000. find that airport again. Rock County. Let's see. Airnav.com. Where are you at? Let's type in Rock. That is a lot. Let's try Rock County. See what comes up. It must not be called Rock County anymore. Okay. Let's look up Rockford. Chicago Rockford International Airport. I'm going to assume that's Greater Rockford. KRFD. There, that airport looks like the one we landed at. Okay, Janesville was north of Rock County. Beloit is this that we're flying over right now. So there's the airport. So Janesville is just past that. We're now passing Beloit. Up ahead is Rockford. So what airport is that? Okay, it's Southern Wisconsin Regional. So it's no longer called Rock County, it's called Southern Wisconsin Regional. Boy, I'm gonna have to make those notes. So I got to make sure when the other simulators go through that they actually go to the right, because they'll do the touch and go at the same airport. So based on where the VOR is at, the airport should be just to our left. Kind of glad I decided to fly in this area. This area was not quite what I expected. 6.8 miles. Yeah, so that's Rockford right there. Looking back at Beloit. And that freeway goes somewhere. Maybe Dubuque. Not really sure. It might go off to Dubuque. It could go off to Moline. Well, or it could go... No, see. No, not Polo. Maybe Davenport. I don't know. I'm, like, looking at the map to see where that road would actually go. But the Sublogic map doesn't have roads drawn on them. The USA East and USA West one does, though. Sublogic scenery packs, but that's for Flight Simulator 4 and ATP. Alright, 10 miles away. Let's start our descent. There. Is that it? This right here? I don't know if that's it or not. Something's... I think that's it. I think that's it. Flaps were pulling down. Yeah, you can see it just right past it. See that? Ah, I zoomed out too much. That is Rockford right there that we're looking at. think I see the runway. I think it might be going like that. Let's move over here. Close enough to see it yet. We just have to wait until we get a little bit closer. There. No idea where the runway's at. I know there is, it's shaped like a triangle, so there's one this way, there's one this way, and there should be one like in the direction that we're headed, and it's just hard to make. Oh, well, we're completely off here. All right, we're going to turn this way then. We will land on runway 18. trying to make my way over there. Oh, don't tell me we just passed it. We did. Let's see if we can get landed here. On the runway, preferably. Maybe we'll actually do it here. See, can we find the fuel box? Mr. Fuel Box, where are you at? Heck if I know. I have no idea. You know, I was going to say I would park off into the corner, but it's hard to see any corner when everything is, like, dark, so I think we'll just park it right here. And it's hard to say. I mean, that over there could be it. I don't know. We're still doing good on fuel. I think we'll be fine. Alright, we are here at Greater Rockford, which is what, Rockford International or something like that now. It was a bit of a long flight, but we did a touch and go over at Janesville at Rock County, which is actually not called that anymore, and then came over to Rockford. So, I guess I'm glad we did a touch and go at Rock County. It's not called that, but yet we've got this little connection between Rock County and Greater Rockford, so that's cool. Anyway, thanks for joining me on this flight, and if you liked it, thumbs up and subscribe and be a part of our killer community and ring that notification bell so that way you know when the next flight is uploaded to this channel. Could be C64, Amiga, any number of things. But other than that, thanks for watching, and I will see you on the next leg of our journey.